All right, let's get right into it. My question to you this morning is this. Are you standing? Are you standing? Ephesians chapter 6 verse 11 states the following. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Now, this is so important for you as a believer. Okay? Do not think that you can handle the devil in your own strength. God has never intended us to handle the devil in our own strength. Even Michael, when he came to fight Satan himself, he never said, I even rebuke you. He says, the Lord rebuke you. In other words, when we do stuff, we use the name of Jesus. So in the name of Jesus, I rebuke you. In other words, you are using Jesus' power, Jesus' authority, Jesus delegated authority onto this earth. Now, it's so important that we understand this. But yet, there are Christians still thinking that they can go out and face the devil in their own strength. You are going to come very short. There have been many Christians who have gone outside of their level of authority where they've grown to and taken on things that they should never have. There was a very well-known evangelist who went and took on the principality of America. He was taken out. I know of big preachers that are coming to Africa, challenging Gomas and things, and they get taken out. Why? Because they have not operated within the authority and understood to apply everything. You know, we make a joke and say the devils in Africa are different from those in the States. Now, what are we talking about? We are talking about every believer getting into a place where you actually carry the authority to turn things. How do I do that? The Bible is very clear. We have to put on the armor of God so that we can stand against the wiles of the devil. So no matter what the devil throws at you, you can stand against it because you have your armor on and you are ready for this. Many of these preachers were blasé about this, and they did not have the armor on and did not know what it was like to come in contact with the demonic world like they had. Remember this. The first world countries, it's not as evident as it is in Africa what real demonic onslaught looks like. They don't have some Gormas and things practicing the way we do. So we have got a very much more real experience when it comes to the spiritual world than many first world countries. But that doesn't make an excuse. Right now, there are many Christians in South Africa that are not putting on the armor, and they are taking on things in the spirit world, and they are not ready to handle it. And so I want to encourage you. Go and make sure that you carry the armor of God before you attack or take on everything in the spirit world. Make sure that you understand the armor. All right, now I don't have time to go through the whole armor and teach it to you right now. I've taught it extensively in our sessions. So you please go to YouTube and go and look for the Armor of God teachings from Arthur Frost, and you'll find it there. All right, I've taught it in the Bible College. I've taught it in our feeds. And I'm telling you now, we have to know our weaponry, and we have to know what it stands for. Okay? Now, in our salvation is saying, listen, do you know your position in Christ? Do you know that you are born again? Do you know that you're under the authority of Jesus Christ? Breastplate of righteousness is the right standing with God. Do you understand the power of the blood of Jesus? All right, and how that affects you and how you can use it as a weapon. Every part of this is part of the weaponry that we use against the devil. All right, the belt of truth. Do you allow the Holy Spirit to minister to you, to lead you, to bring you into all truth? The Holy Spirit always works together with the word, which is the sword. The belt is attached to the sword, right? The sword is the word of God. Are you releasing the word? Are you speaking the word? Are you just doing what God has called you to do? Feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Do you operate out of peace, letting peace lead you wherever you go? These weapons are important. The shield of faith. The Bible says the shield of faith will quench every single fiery dart that the devil throws at you. So when there's a thing coming and it looks like you are down and out, you stand up and say, in God I trust. In the name of Jesus Christ, I thank you, God, that this is going to turn around. You must understand, when we walk in with a shield, with armor on, I tell you what, we start taking ground. But my question remains, are you putting your armor on? Do you even know what your armor is? So if you want to pray for your businesses, pray for your family, oppose the devil's tactics, you've got to know your armor and you've got to stand. Are you standing your ground? Or are you allowing the devil to knock you left and right? You've got to know how to stand. You've got to know how to release the power of God. You've got to know how to call on God. Because these things are going to let us get the victory in Jesus' name. And so this morning, I want to challenge us as we come around the table and say, Lord Jesus, bring us into the place of victory in Jesus' name. Let every Christian be standing with the full armor on, ready to do what God has called us to do. And we will see the glory, the majesty, the victory in Jesus' name. If you are concerned about your area, about your house, about your business, about your suburb, about your nation, saints, let's get the armor on in Jesus' name. Father, we come before you right now in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, that we love you. We care for, that you care for us. And Lord, that we just honor you and exalt you today. And Lord, I thank you that on the night that you were betrayed, you took bread and broke it and said, this is my body that was broken for you. Take in remembrance of me. Lord, that you loved us so much that you said, this is my blood that was shed for you. Take in remembrance of me. And Lord, that when we get together, Lord, that we will take of the elements right now. And as we do, we will release the dunamis power of God to flow through us. And Lord, that we will see the power of God in everything that we do in Jesus' name. Father, I pray right now that you will raise the church of Jesus Christ up. And Lord, that we will stand solid. And Lord, that we will stand on post. And Lord, that we will maintain the ground that has been given us in Jesus' name. Father, I pray your blessing and anointing upon each and everyone in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen and amen. Let's partake together. Lord, right now in the name of Jesus, I release the dunamis power of God over our physical bodies. I thank you, Lord, that the Spirit of God that dwells inside of us quicken our mortal bodies. I command every single symptom of sickness to go. Thank you, Lord, that we walk in divine health. Divine healing is ours. Father, I thank you right now that everything that the devil has tried will come to null in Jesus' mighty name. I thank you, Lord, that we are healed, walking in divine health and divine healing in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody said, amen and amen. Well, saints, I want to bless you this morning. I want to tell you that Jesus Christ is alive. We are moving in might and power, and we are going to do what Jesus Christ has called us to do. Amen. I've had a wonderful time in Gauteng, and I tell you what, God is busy with each and every one of us. And I tell you, we are going to see the victories, we are going to see the power of God, and we are going to see God do something in this nation. So, I want to remind you, all right, we have received all of the books of Revelation now. And so we've got enough books in stock for everybody. I want to encourage you, get the book of Revelation in your hands. Know the times and the seasons. We are in a time of earnest deception. I'm seeing the stuff creeping into the churches. I'm very concerned by the fact that many charismatic churches are starting to preach against the rapture now. Saints, we need to be careful. You do not want to be in tribulation. In the tribulation, because you have not looked for the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. I tell you what, this is critical. This is such a dangerous season to be compromising on some of the basic truths in the gospel. So please get hold of the book of Revelation, whether you do it via YouTube, whether you get the book in your hand, study it. Know the season that you are in. Because the Bible is very clear that Satan is trying to deceive the body of Christ in this season. As we come closer to the end times, the Bible says, and it's full of it, it says, be careful of false teachers and false prophets that are coming around. You have to have a discernment level that is high and awake and ready. And that is one of the reasons why I took so much time to prepare for the book of Revelation, so that I could give the body of Christ a sound, solid tool to fight from. And so I want to encourage you, get this revelation under your belt so that you get it, you understand it, and most of all, that you don't have any fear. One of the things that is coming across is the level of fear. And I'm telling you now, we need to reverse that in the name of Jesus. So if you're still looking for a book, drarthurfrost.com. All right? Then I want to say this. We are going to pray. There are so many incredible things turning in the positive for our nation. I want to say thank you to the saints for praying. Thank you for standing in the gap, being there week after week and pushing in. But I'll tell you right now, there is one thing we need to pray about this morning. And that is this. They are trying very hard to bring a global lockdown, all right, over all the nations. The biggest and the most important reason is they are trying to stop President Trump from becoming president. Because they know that if he gets in, there's going to be a lot of change and America is going to rise up again. Please do not sit down and think that this is the end time and that everything's coming to an end. No. This is the time where the church is only starting to rise up. The true apostles around the world are going to be standing up in this season, leading the way, showing what to do, and you are going to see a move of God come across our nations. So don't think that this is the time where we come and say, Ach, Here, vat ons weg. Lord, take us away. It's out of here because of stuff. No, you are going to be taken out on the height of revival, on the height of things moving, on the height of God doing stuff. So I want to tell you right now, God is about to do something major in our nation. So keep praying. Standing with, we are going to resist this. We are going to turn this in Jesus' mighty name. We are not going to allow the devil a foothold in our nation. And so, saints, I want you to understand, there is an urgency in our season, an urgency in our time. And so I want to encourage you, tonight is Bible College. All right, so come and join us at the college from 6:30. And then 7:30 is our Kings and Priests time, where we are praying with business people. If you're a business person, I challenge you to come and join us. Come, let us teach you, let us pray with you, and let us get these businesses operating on godly principle so that we can see the power of God made manifest in your business and in your family. And then I want to remind you, we've got the Fire Conference coming up. I really want to encourage every single one to make an effort to get there. The devil has been wreaking havoc in the last 6 months across this nation. It's been one of the biggest spiritual attacks that I've ever seen, all right, in the body of Christ. And people don't even realize the severity of what's been going on. Come, let's get under the anointing. Let's break these attacks of our lives. So I want to encourage you, get to the Fire Conference if you can. Okay? Club together in four or five of you in a car. Get down to Cape Town, Rebecca Steele, and we are going to trust God for the supernatural. Because we need to break the stuff off the body of Christ. And this is not about playing games. This is about equipping the saints. This is about getting you ready so that you can fight. And it's going to be an exciting season that we are in. Seeing the body of Christ stand up and push back what the devil's tried in Jesus' name. Amen? All right. So right now, we are going to pray. We're going to pray over our nation. And we are going to be praying. This whole week I'm going to be praying against this potential lockdown that they're trying. So let's pray. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, we come before you. And Lord, we come against this idea of a global lockdown in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I bind that spirit of Antichrist. I bind that spirit that is trying to bring the economic situation down in every nation. Father, I release the anointing of God. Lord, we stand together in South Africa and we say, this will not happen on our watch and in our nation in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we thank you that we can stand in agreement. And Lord, I pray right now that you are going to move by your spirit in our land. Lord, we release the anointing and the power of God over South Africa. And we call South Africa into its role, into its rightful place on the world stage. Lord, I pray that every believer will do what they meant to do, that they will be obedient. And Father, that we will declare blessing and life in every area where we stay. And Lord, right now, I thank you for our businesses. Thank you, Lord, that we can declare life over our business. We speak blessing over our business. Thank you, Lord, that as we build altars, Lord, that our businesses are blessed. And Lord, not only our businesses blessed, supernatural deals, divine connections, supernatural contracts are physically seen over our businesses in Jesus' name. Lord, we release your blessing and anointing over each and every one in Jesus' mighty name. I thank you, Lord, that our economy is blessed. Thank you, God, that interest rates are coming down. And Lord, that it will be by a substantial amount in Jesus' mighty name. Lord, I release your blessing and anointing upon each and every one. Thank you, Lord, that we can pray for the peace of Israel, a peace of Jerusalem. Pray for the blessing of Israel. Thank you, God, that that war will come to an end quickly in the mighty name of Jesus. And everybody said, amen and amen. Amen, folks. I thank you very much for standing and praying together. I know that God is in control of our nation. Amen. All right, let's get to our declaration. In Jesus' name, I declare by faith that I walk in divine favor. I have preferential treatment, supernatural increase, restoration, increased assets, great victories, recognition, prominence, petitions granted, policies and rules changed, battles won that I did not have to fight, all because of the blessing and the favor of God on my life. So saints, go out with might, go out with valor, and see God make a difference in Jesus' name. Love you lots.